How does it feel to officially be honoured today, especially by critics?
It's wonderful. It's overwhelming. It's a wonderful feeling, and it's great that the show's getting the recognition that it so deserves. And if that's coming through my performance, that's what can I say? That's wonderful. But for me, it's more important that we get to tell our story every night.
I think obviously this is a story that clearly means a lot to a lot of audiences that have been lucky enough to see it. Can you talk about what this role, what this production means to you, though?
Well, it's meant so much to me for the last 3.5 years. I got involved in the very first workshop, very early stages of it. I really helped create the role, and no one else has done it yet. So that's such a lovely, lucky thing for an actor to have, is to do something that's sort of to tread a path that no one else has tread before. But I do hope that it gets to be seen and gets to be played by as many people as humanly possible, because it just does such wonderful things for a person that comes in contact with it. For me, the emotional core of the story is the story of a single mother and an only child. It's the domestic aspects, it's about a boy, it's about coming of age, it's about boy turning into a man, and sort of it's about all those things that we all inevitably go through at some point in our lives. It's going from child to adult and learning the ways of the world and learning where you fit into the world.
In terms of fitting into the world, what makes London such unique and special live theatre capital?
The diversity of the shows, the diversity of the casts, and the diversity of the audience. It's never the same, and that's what's so brilliant, is that we're not preaching to the converted. You know, sometimes we have people coming in that may not necessarily know what the show's about, may not agree with some of the politics, but that's the beauty of the capital, is that we get to show our piece of work to as many people as possible.
It's interesting you talk about that, not all audiences agreeing with the politics of the show. Do you think that is an important function of live theatre, in particular as an art form, to challenge audiences?
Yeah, absolutely. I think theatre is all about asking questions of the audience and sort of education, you know, for the audience and the actors. We all hope to learn things when we go to the theatre. I mean, I think it's commonly known, isn't it, that most people, when they come out of the theatre, it's far more interesting to have a debated conversation about whether you hated it or loved it than just to say, it was okay. You know, we really want to inspire those conversations to happen.
My name is Dan Gillespie-Sells. I'm the composer of Everybody's Talking About Jamie.
And it's amazing to have you here with us today. How proud are you to see your young star collecting a Best Newcomer Award from the critic?
We're so delighted for him. So delighted for him. He's so hardworking and so talented, and he gets the show. He gets what it's really about. He gets what it needs to be about. And he delivers it with layers and layers and layers, which is so important for Jamie. You know, there's a risk that it could be camp or something, or, you know, just a bit off. When you have an effeminate lead character, there really hasn't been an effeminate lead character in a show like this, not authentically effeminate male lead character in a show as our hero at the centre of it. And it only works because John can pull off that performance. He can give it depth, and he can make the audience warm to him and believe him and believe in him. And he can do it and be 16 at the same time, you know, which is a real skill. I mean, it's a real skill to maintain that belief that he's 16 and that his heart is full of possibility, and he's in this moment where he's going to define something about himself for the rest of his life. And, you know, it's so exciting. And it's thrilling to watch when he performs it, because he's just got so much skill. It's unbelievable. It's a lot of it is just about trying to avoid the obvious. Not for the sake of it, but just trusting your instincts and going with whatever your instincts say, even though they might not be the obvious thing to do in that particular time in a musical. And I'm very new to this, so I actually came at it from a place of complete ignorance. And, you know, just as a pop writer. And what I've learned is the fact that you have to just be really precise. You have to be really clear and precise about what you're saying at every single moment. And it's made my songwriting better. I've improved as a songwriter through doing musical theatre, definitely, 100%. The emotional core of it is a boy and his mum. And really, fundamentally, that's the relationship that everyone warms to, everyone believes in, everyone gets, is that relationship between a mother's desire to protect a child who stands out from the crowd. Almost like a celebration of that kind of fundamental triumph of humanity, in that you've got a child who's a bit of an oddball, and you've got a mum who just gets him. He just gets him and supports him and loves him. And you see that being pulled around in our show. You see it being challenged and tested. And you see her make mistakes, and you see him, you know, regale against them. And but what you learn is that she's always going to be there for him, and that, you know, without her, he'd never be able to do it. Because what he tries to do is quite big. He tries to figure out who he is, and that's big for everyone when you're 16.
I guess my final question, obviously, we've seen many of the great West End musical productions transfer to screen. Do you think that this is a production that has that in its future? Is that the ultimate destiny of this story?
I mean, I don't know about the ultimate destiny. I feel, though, that there's something naturally cinematic about this kind of storytelling. You know, I would love it to be a musical film, because it gives us a chance to tell the story even more widely, and it gives us a chance to tell the story in a slightly different way with different details and different elements. And I think it's just really important to have that.